CSS comprises of two things. So first we have seen the part one, that's fonts and advanced fonts. So how can you add the custom fonts and all from the particular website? So in today's class, we are going with a part two. So under CSS level two. So in this lecture, we are going to learn about CSS box model. So what we are going to study? So in the previous class, we have gone with the CSS fonts. So in today's class, we are going to discuss about CSS box model. So box model allows us to precisely dictate how we want the HTML elements to look. Okay. So box will have four sides. So four sides, we can consider it as top, bottom, left, and right. Okay. So in the box model, we can have set of contents inside the particular box. So this will help you to create a group of elements or group of text inside one particular box. So basic box model looks like this. So content, the box will consist of four sides. So this one, we take it as top. This one is bottom and left, and this one is right. So if you want the content for content, this here is the content. So content, we can have n number of text. So with the background color, background text, everything. If we want the space around the content, if you want the space around the content, then you consider the concept called padding. So padding means it is going to add in this particular space to the content. So adding the space around the content, we call it as padding. Okay. So now the outer layout is considered as a margin. So first is the margin. Next, we can apply the border. Next, you can give the padding and followed by the content. So border and padding are the optional elements, whereas margin and content should be given for a box model. Okay. Because you are creating a box. So box means you have to give the margin of that particular box. So inside the box, you can have the content here. So there are four components. So margin, border, padding, followed with the content. So we can apply the margin of the for a particular box. So followed by the margin, we can have a border. So border followed with padding. So padding will add the extra space around the content. So margin, border will add extra space around the margin. Understand? So padding will add extra space around the content, and border will have extra space around the margin. Okay. So, but you can also specify each side. So as I already told you, there are four sides. So this one we take top, this one is taken bottom, this one is left, this one is right. So for each of the thing, so for each side, you can have top margin, top border, top padding, bottom border, and bottom margin. So similarly, you can have the parameters for left as well as right also. So next, let's explore some examples of this. Okay. That means you are going to create the content, the box, inside the box. So how you put the content inside the box? So let's go with some of the examples. So jump onto Autumn Text Editor now. So Autumn Text Editor. So go for file. Take it as new file. So this is the new file I have taken. So that is HTML file. So under the HTML, go and select the HTML content here. So and save the particular file. So while saving, you take it as boxmodel.html. So give it as boxmodel.html. Save. So here you should be getting like a boxmodel.html. So similarly, now you come for the file. So take the new file that is for CSS. So go for the plain text and choose SCSS. So SCSS, it is showing like this. So go for file and save the content. So while saving, give it as boxmodel.css. Save this particular content. So now you come for the HTML file. Okay, you are creating a box. So start with a HT. So language, English, everything is D1. So what can be the title? So you give the title as box model. Okay, come for the body part. So body part, you take one particular heading. So you take something called, some attribute called top. So similarly, you go for heading 2 and give it as bottom. Okay, so now I have to create a box for content. Content is top and the other one is bottom. So content, you have to create one box for this one and another box for this one. So how you are going to create the box for this content? So content has been already given. So we have taken it as top and bottom. What is the content you have taken? So content is taken as top as well as bottom. So now you save this particular thing. So save this particular thing. Go for file, go with a save. Okay, so now I'm going to run this HTML file. So go for edit, you give it as copy path. So under copy path, take the new window and paste it here. So control V, now you are getting the one as top, the other one you are getting it as bottom. So now you have to create the box for that particular thing. Okay. So as you can see, we are creating different box models. So one for top, the other one is for bottom. So top will take a different specification and bottom will take different. That means you use different boxes for each one. So as you go with a different boxes, so you, here you have to go with a different thing. So here you give it as ID. So ID, you give something called top. Okay. So similarly, come for H2. So take the ID. So ID, you take it as bottom. Because when you use the ID, because you want different formats for each of the thing. So different colors, different background colors, different font settings. Then you have to go with a word called ID. It is for CSS selectors. So CSS selectors, we have two things. One is the class, the other one is ID. So class will be applied for table, form, div, etc. But for paragraph and heading, you will be having the concept called ID. Okay, so ID has been applied here. So now you come for the CSS file. So under CSS file, you have to take two ID. So how you represent the ID? By using hash. So box model, you come for the, by using hash, top, top. Okay. So inside the top, first you have to create the box. So in order to create the box, so first thing you have to take is the border. So border, you take it some 5px with a color. So color, I will be taking solid blue. Okay. So settings for top I have given. So now I have to link the CSS file with my HTML file. So go for HTML file, come for the head section. After the title, take the link. Okay. So link, in the link, you give the references, your CSS file name. So CSS file name is box model. So save the contents, go for the web page and see here you have applied the border like this. So border. So when you apply the border, you are getting something called top in with a border. Okay. You are applying the border with the top. Okay. Right. So now you come after the border. So now you give the margin. So margin, while giving the margin, you have, as I have told, you will be getting margin left, margin right, margin top, margin bottom, because you will be, you should apply it for all the things, or you can give directly the values. So for top, you should give it as 10 px, and for the bottom, so top, right, so it will be using this format. So margin will go with a format. So I will be giving the margin like this. So margin colon. So first it will be top. Next it will be right. Next it will be bottom. Next it will be left. Okay. So this is the concept. So margin you should give like this. So top you have taken 10. So right 20. Next for bottom you take it something 100, and for the next thing 100 ticks. So top, right, bottom, left. So you give the margin like this, save the content and go and see where the top will come. So top is coming for this particular thing. So you are getting the top like this. So here you give it 400 px. So next you go with 100 px. So now you see, so how you are getting your web page. So web page is like this. Okay. So now after the margin, so as you have only one thing, so you can go for the width. Okay. So width should be given 25%. It will be in terms of 20% only. So I'll be giving text. So there is a text. It should be aligned to center. Okay. So when you apply the settings and see it here, so you are getting the everything in top. So what you are getting width. So if you go with this, here you can see the size of the box is keep ranging. So if you reduce, it will go, it will, if you reduce also, you will be getting like this. So this is the demo of the width attribute. So if you give it width, so you'll be getting like this. So from the bottom, it is at the speed of 400 px. And from the top, it is at the distance of 10 px. And from the left, it is at the distance of 20. So from the right, it is at the distance of, so it is at the distance of 100 px. So from the bottom, it is at the distance of 400 px. Okay. So now this is the top what we have created. So now you come for the font. Okay. So font, you go with, as I have told, so many font families. So font family, you take it cursive and see how you are getting this particular web page. So if you take cursive, it comes in. Font style is being changed here. So that is the font family. So, or you can go with a font style, font size, font style, etc. So font style, I will be giving it as italic. So if you take italic, so see, it is bending slightly. So this is the top demo. So, or you can go with a color also. So color, you give it something called blue. Okay. So if you give the color as blue, so here you can see everything is in blue color. So kindly change these settings. So color, you give red. Okay. So save. Go for the settings. There you can see top with different color. So now you come for the bottom. So bottom is not changed. So take it bottom. So bottom, you give the border. So first thing, in order to create the box model. So take the border. So border, you give it as some different colors. Four pairs, solid blue we have taken. So red is also taken. So now you go with violet, solid violet. So now you have to give it the width. So width, I'll be giving something called 50%. So next, if you want the content padding, so what the padding will do, it will add the extra space around the content. So what is the content of bottom you are having? This is the content. So what it will do? So first, let's go with a border and then you describe with the padding. So first see how the contents of the bottom you are getting. So bottom you are getting like this. Okay. So now you specify the margin. So how much? How much margin you can provide, or you can go with something called text alignment. So text align, you give it center. So after the text align, now you see. So how you are getting this particular thing. So there is so much space between this and this. So now you see this is the border. This is the content. So what comes in between border and content? And anybody can tell what comes between border and content? So totally four attributes you are having. So content, padding, border, margin. Okay. So what comes between border and content?
Padding.
Padding. Okay. So now what the padding will do? It will add extra space in between border and the content. So it adds the extra space between border and the content. So for that, I'll be adding the padding here. So padding, you take it something called percent. Okay. So it is 200px, sorry. So now you see how you are getting the thing. So let's refresh. Now you see you are getting like this. So padding, you have been added the content like this. So suppose if you give the padding as some 50px. So save the contents and see. Here you can see this is the top. And here you have given this is the border. So border you have given. So now you can also set the margin for that. Okay. So adding the margin. So as I've already told, you can specify everything inside margin only. So margin, first you will be getting top. So top, you give something called 100px because it comes below top. So 100px. Next up, left. So you give it something called 20px. And bottom, you give some 100px. And right, you give some 50px. Okay, so that you have to see and then you have to adjust. So even, so here you see, here you can see. So how I am getting this particular content. So this is the margins. So the from this particular page, so this is the margin line. This is the border line. So margin, how much you have given like this? So from top, it should be this much. From bottom, it should be this much. From left, it should be this. And from right, it should be this much. So that one I'm giving in terms of px. So top, I have taken 100 and left 20. So right 100 and bottom, it is 50px. So here you can see this is a much, not much distance. So this is the demo of the box model. So that means you have created the box like this. So now for that one, you can have background color. So background color you can take, or background image also you can put. So what is the font color you have taken for the bottom? It is black color. So background color, you give it as yellow. So color, you give it as red. Okay. So now for the bottom, I have specified the background color, and this one here you can see that. So it is coming like this. Okay. So now you can have different font families, font styles also. So how to add the font? So how to add the font from the website? So I have already told in the previous window how to create a new, how to take from this one. So choose different fonts. So for that, you go with fonts.google.com. Okay. So here it will show you for Google fonts, browse fonts here. And you can use anything. So in Roboto, there are 12 styles. Poppins, so choose something different. So let's see this style. Select. So when you select, it will show you the link as well as CSS rules. So what it tells when you select, you see, to embed a font, copy the code into the head of your HTML. So copy this code and place it in head of the HTML. So this is the HTML page. Go for the head. So this is head. Before head, I'm placing all these lines. So save the content. Now see, come for the down CSS rules. So under CSS rules, you take the font family. So copy this particular content and paste it in CSS part. So CSS part. So here I will be applying Control V. Okay. So save this content and now refresh and see how the font you are getting. So font you have got in that particular format. Okay. So here it is showing like bottom here. Understood. So that is adding the custom fonts. So if you want for a font family for top, if you want to add the different thing, you can go here. So choose any other different fonts that makes difference. So choose the different thing. Web as new. Okay. So use this style. When you use this style, it is giving like this. So here you should get plus link. So if you get that one, then you can apply that particular style. So some of the links cannot be opened. So you have to check it with that. So click on that, you select the style. So if you are not applying, so you have to choose different files styles like that. So which font you can select? Dancing Script, Cairo, Allison. So if you select, you should get this particular content. So kindly go for fonts.google.com. So take this Roboto. So in that you are having so many styles. I go with select style, this one. If you select this style, you should get like this. So copy this Roboto, copy. So go for the HTML. So under the box model, so you press enter and Control V. So I am using this Roboto for top. So go for the Roboto, copy this CSS rules. So I'm applying this for top item. So where is top in CSS? So under the font family, you remove this particular thing and paste that one. So Control V. So save this particular content and now you refresh the box model and see how you are getting. So top, it has taken different fonts. Okay. So this is the demo of box model. So box model, you can have four parameters: margin, so border, next padding to add the extra content around the text what you are going to give. So I hope you all have got understood this particular box model. So you can have font family, or you can have a text for text also. You can have text rendering. So text transform you can take if it is in top. So how you are given the text? So it is in uppercase. So if for transform, you can take it in lowercase also. So save the content and see. So how you are getting it in lowercase. So bottom, it is given in lowercase now. So similarly, you can go with that after the transform. So you can take it full width and see how each property is going to work. So full width. So this is the full width content you have taken. This will be the change. So after the transform, now you can apply text decoration. Sorry, I can take text decoration style. You can take it as dash, dotted, double, solid, wavy. So I take this particular content wavy and see. So this is the text content I'm getting. So nothing more changes you are having on this. So you take it as dotted, save the content. So no changes you have been seeing here. So this is up to some of the how to create the custom fonts and all. So have you understood up to here?
Yes, sir.
So this particular video lecture will be uploaded in my YouTube channel. So kindly kindly go through, and then using the recorded sessions, you can go through and work on that particular thing. So this is up to today's class. So this is up to CSS level 2. So CSS level 2 class is going to complete today. So from tomorrow, we shall see Bootstrap. Okay. So till then, take care. Meet you in the next class.